Hi friends, today I would like to discuss with you important and significant provisions of the Negotiable Instrument Act and recently landmark judgment delivered by the Honorable Supreme Court of India as well as some High Courts of India. We know that Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act is very famous because every day innumerable commercial transactions are taking place. Every day the cases are being filed up before the Metropolitan Magistrate Court owing to the reason that the checks issued by the parties are being bounced. Therefore, once the check bounced due to many of the reasons like insufficient amount in the account or stop payment or whatever reasons, for such a bouncing of the case, the complainant has got a right and he has got the remedy to file a case before the magistrate court or judicial magistrate first class. This remedy is provided under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act. The very important thing pertaining to Section 138 of the cases is that the complainant should be able to recover the debt. The debt must be legally recoverable debt. Then and then the complainant would be able to recover it from the accused, and there are chances that the complainant may win the case and he may recover the amount of the said check. Therefore, the amount stated in the check must be a legally recoverable debt. If it is not a legally recoverable debt, then the court cannot pass orders and complainant will not get success in the matter. For example, if I have received a material of rupees 10 lakhs from you on credit basis, and to discharge my liability, I have issued a check to the seller, and because of any of the reasons the said check got bounced, in that case the seller in whose favor I have issued the check has a right to file a case against me, and in that case it can be called that the said debt is a legally recoverable debt as there was a business transaction between me and the seller of the goods. On the contrary, suppose I have issued a check to an NGO as a charity or donation, but there is no compulsion on my part, but out of my own will and wish I have given a check. In case if such a check gets bounced, in that case there is no legal liability or duty on my parts. Therefore, this debt cannot be called as a legally recoverable debt. In case if the person in whose favor the said check has been issued, if he goes to the court, he will not get succeeded because this is not a legally recoverable debt. That is the soul of this Section 138. This is very basic things. The complainant should be filed in a stipulated period as provided under the law. That we know. However, especially today we are going to discuss here the amendment carried out by virtue of adding Section 143A by the Parliament. The Parliament by Section 143A of the Negotiable Instrument Act has provided the remedy that the complainant can make an application to the court and he can seek up to 20% of the amount of the check as an interim compensation from the accused. So, question arises before us whether a court can grant such a interim compensation suo moto. Suo moto means without there being any application filed by the complainant. The answer to this question is that suo moto cannot grant such a compensation or interim compensation. Therefore, there must be an application forwarded or filed by the complainant seeking up to 20% of the compensation from the accused, and the both party would be heard by the Honorable Court, and thereafter the order would be passed. Once such an order is passed by the court, in that case the said amount has to be paid by the accused within the span of 60 days from the date of order. However, the stay duration of 60 days may be extended up to 30 days, that is further 30 days, provided that the judge who passes the order records the reasoning in his order for such a further delay of 30 days. What would happen if the accused get acquitted? In such a cases, the amount so paid by the accused as an interim compensation, he has a right to recover it from the complainant along with interest at the rate prevailing in the financial year, that is beginning of the financial year, as per the IRBI rules. Not only the accused has the right to get the amount of interim compensation back, but apart from that, he will also be able to get the interest there too, as per the rates applicable in the financial year. In case if the accused get convicted, it means complainant succeeded in that case, the amount so paid by the accused, that is interim compensation, would be adjusted towards the final amount of the fine. For example, if the amount of the check is 10 lakh rupees, in that case, if the interim compensation was awarded 2 lakh rupees, then such a 2 lakh earlier paid as an interim compensation would be deducted from the final amount. But as per the provision of this 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, the court has power to grant twice of the amount of the check or 2 years maximum punishment or both. It depends upon the court. Court may not grant twice of the amount. Court may give some extra amount like 10%, 20% more. It is up to the court. Now, question arises before us is that whether this amendment carried out by the Parliament by virtue of Section 143A of the Negotiable Instrument Act, whether it has prospective effect or it has retrospective effect. We know that retrospective effect means applicable to the past, and prospective effect means applicable to the transaction henceforth onwards. Therefore, this 138 law is a criminal law, and we know that the principle of interpretation, applying the principle of interpretation of statute, the retrospective effect cannot be given to the penal statute. Likewise, in the instant case, only prospective effect could be given to this amendment that has been laid down by the Honorable Supreme Court in one of the judgment called G.J. Raja versus Tej Raj Surana. I will also put the wording in my comment box. This is the judgment delivered by the Honorable Supreme Court of India in SLP 3342 of 2019. G.J. Raja versus Tej Raj Surana. In this case, the Honorable Supreme Court has said that Section 143A of the Negotiable Instrument Act cannot be given retrospective effect. It can only be given prospective effect. Therefore, those offences under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act which have been committed prior to this Amendment Act, then such amendment will not be applicable, will not be given to the complainant. The offences must have been committed after the amendment came into picture. Therefore, the amendment came into picture on 2nd of August 2018, because on that day, assent to the said proposal has been obtained from the President of India. Therefore, this amendment under Section 143A are applicable onwards 2nd August 2018. Therefore, before all such offences which have been committed prior to that, this amendment is not applicable at all, because retrospective effect cannot be given to this amendment. Only prospective effect can be given. Therefore, This is very much clear because this is the principle of criminal law. On that particular day, this amendment were not carried out. In the year of, for example, in the year of 2017-2015, there was no amendment. Therefore, obviously, even if the cases have been filed prior thereto, and such a cases are pending in the magistrate court or JMFC court, even after 2018, no such a effect could be given to those such a cases. If the magistrate has taken a cognizance and given the benefit under this provision, then such a order is bad in law. The conclusion is that only prospective effect can be given to section 143A of the Negotiable Instrument Act, and no retrospective effect can be given to the said provision. In my another video, I would like to cover the other judgments and other provisions pertaining to this. Thanks for your cooperation in listening to me.